Inquiring minds want to know how to make a YouTube video on your computer. So we're gonna dive in, we're gonna answer that question for you today and show you. Okay, so my first reaction actually when I saw this question is, you don't make a video on your computer. But I guess they're probably talking about the editing.
That would be my initial, they're getting the footage somewhere else.
I mean, because I actually do make videos on my computer all the time, not that I put on YouTube or not that I, you know, that I so right. for example, on my MacBook right here, you know, when I'm making a video on my computer, it's when I'm communicating with my team. So I open it up and I use the webcam. Maybe they're seeing my face or I'm recording the screen, but that's not a video for YouTube. So that's kind of what came to my mind is like, if you're going to make a video for YouTube.
I think maybe they're saying, you know, make a video for YouTube and the editing process, putting it all together, uploading it to YouTube, as opposed to hiring out and having someone do that. You know, you're just doing it yourself. By the same token, you know, most laptops like this do have their own little camera, right? And so if they're asking, should we make YouTube videos with that camera, can it be done? Of course it can be done.
So let's talk about both sides. The sides are the reason why it's probably a bad idea, at least just to start to use your webcam, is one, the angle is bad. Typically you want the camera to be level or slightly above, just for lighting and whatnot. But if you've got the webcam, typically you're looking down, maybe it's going up your nostrils or looking at your double chin.
And I must say, in its defense, I have had to make videos using the webcam video for things that I have to send people right away and I had no other way of doing it. And so I'll put it up on a thing or wherever and make sure the lighting is okay. And
so by default, the angle is just naturally bad. You've got to prop it up.
And the camera itself isn't great. I mean, the resolution it's shooting, I don't know what it is, but it's not, it won't natively come in as this bright, crisp, clear.
Another default that you could easily fix, especially with a laptop, because it's portable, but usually the background is bad. You know, usually your computer's at a desk, and so just your office behind you or your bedroom behind you, that's usually a bad background. Yeah. So if you're filming on your webcam, if you have a MacBook, you could obviously choose what your background is. But the other thing is that by default, the lighting is usually bad. You know, sometimes the dark area, if you're sitting your desk against a wall, then it's darkness and all the light is around you. Yeah. So the lighting is bad by default.
Yeah.
So if you've got your MacBook and you can come and put it in front of a window.
Which I had to yesterday.
And prop it up.
Literally, it was the best I could do.
Yeah, so if you prop up your MacBook in front of a window, you get a better angle, you get better lighting.
You look good. I had to do this to self-tape an audition.
You can make it work.
For a Hallmark Christmas movie. And I was in a hotel, and they said, you got to get it to us right now. And I set it up in the window and got the sun was light. It was in Louisiana, and it came in. And I said, I apologize that this is a webcam, but you can see me, and I'm framed nicely, and I had it up right here. It was literally just yesterday, so it's good timing to ask the question.
And you're not going to be able to get, how like this cool background here is blurred. You know, you can't do that with a webcam. You can't get that.
Yeah, it's not the ideal camera. I mean, in a pinch, if you have nothing else, you could open it up and you could walk around with it. I mean, I've seen goofier. But I think probably the primary question is how do I make it once it's filmed?
So one more point and then we'll get into that. The other point is the audio. The MacBook's audio is okay. It's okay, but it's obviously not as good. The audio we're using here is a Zoom H2N mic.
You'll have to go in later when you edit it.
Some computers are better than others with their audio, but anyway, the default is it's not the best. So ideally, I mean, even filming with the camera on your phone is going to be better.
That's true.
Than a webcam. And there's just a lot more energy put into this little teeny thing. It's amazing.
Yes, it is.
I mean, this thing films in 4K. But you'll have better video and audio that you will then put on your computer that you edit. I mean, it's more portable, or you'll have it on a tripod. You'll be able to do panning or whatever type of video you're doing. You can't really put a MacBook webcam on a glide cam. Imagine seeing Devin Supertramp running around with
With an open laptop.
That'd be funny.
Yeah. But the fact is that if someone is asking, how do I make a YouTube video on my computer?
So now let's talk about the editing.
The answer is, which is, it's kind of a funny question because everything is made on a computer now.
It is.
I mean,
so now we'll really answer that side of the question if that's what you're asking. And the first recommendation for somebody who's asking that question, I'm going to recommend the basics. Start with iMovie. If you've got a Mac, it's free.
Yeah.
And iMovie is actually a really good software. You can upgrade later to the Final Cut Pro, which just has more features.
Or if you have a PC,
What would you recommend? Because I don't have a go-to. Premiere. Premiere is my go-to for a PC.
It's Premiere on most PCs, and they do have a trial version. I can't remember. Premiere Lite or Premiere...
Well, because everything now is the Adobe Creative Cloud.
That's all part of their suite.
But you can get it for $20 a month, and maybe they have a trial for a couple weeks or something like that. Or maybe they have a student edition.
It's been a while since I've used the PC, but I remember there was a Premiere something. It had a light name to it. And it was really quite restrictive.
Okay.
I find that iMovie gives you more stuff.
And then the other thing is iMovie comes free on an iPhone. And so imagine this. You don't even have to put it on your computer. Just use this computer. Use the camera that's here. And then use iMovie.
I have not gotten good at that. I definitely prefer this.
So my kids, under my supervision, they have a comedy YouTube channel, Comedy Skits.
Right.
That was like kind of like Studio C or a clean... Saturday Night Live type thing. They'll make their own skits and then they'll edit either on my phone or my wife's phone, and they actually do a pretty good job.
To be able to edit on a phone with your fingers
takes
a millennial skill. You know what I mean? It's like that's kid stuff. It's crazy.
And then if you want another free editing software for a PC, then what you do is open up Google and type in free editing software for PC, and you'll get some options that will come up and use those at your own risk. So now, here's the step-by-steps of how to get started. In fact, I want to demonstrate this. Where's my monopod? Something that will make your videos better. I think it's out in the garage. Let me just grab it real quick.
He's asking me where his monopod is.
Okay, so if you're going to be filming with your phone, then you need a tripod, which I'm using my tripod over there. So this is a monopod, which will stand up. And then I've got on a little adapter that I can put my phone in, and then...
So it's really a monopod tripod, because it actually still uses tripod.
It's got 3 feet.
Yeah.
If I put my DSLR camera on it, that's kind of dangerous, because the weight will make it want to tip. But
that's awesome.
Anyway, this is great. So, you know, put your camera on a tripod. I guess you're not fully seeing it within our frame here, but that's going to really help, you know, and allow you to do a lot more things. Now, when you're using a phone, you can put it in selfie mode, and it's not unless you have the iPhone 10 or whatnot, it's not going to be the full HD.
Right.
But it's really nice to be able to see yourself. Now, right now we're filming on a DSLR camera. In fact, it's the twin of this camera, and it's got a flip screen that when I turn it around, it doesn't have a lens on it. But we would see ourselves, right? We see ourselves right there. I'm waving at myself. That's a big help. You know, if you're filming, you don't have somebody else filming you. You just have to know if you're in the frame. And so if we were using this lens right there, we wouldn't know.
No, we would just kind of have to basically center it the best we could. But turning it around.
Selfie mode.
Yeah. Like you say, you do get less resolution to some degree, but it's still a great picture and you're framed and you look right, you know.
So then I recommend on YouTube going into the search bar and typing in things like this, iMovie orientation for beginners. That's going to orient you kind of around how to use iMovie. Type in how to increase the volume in iMovie. What I mean here is ask specific things.
Right.
If you're trying to figure out the volume, then you can just ask that real specific thing and you'll find ten different tutorials
it's
on
amazing.
That.
Amazing. I've done that so many
times. Another example, how to shorten a video clip in iMovie or how to edit a mistake in iMovie.
Or how come I can't overlay this on that in iMovie? Like there's
and you'll
things
find an
that
answer.
Are frustrating and someone has gone through it and they'll show you a video of how to do it.
So you could film right now and you could start open up iMovie. And you could have an edited amazing movie just by like figuring out, I don't know how to do that. Well, then YouTube it, and 10 minutes later, you'll know how to do that thing. Now, we filmed a video yesterday called How to Shoot a Video That Doesn't Suck. Now, I want you to go back and watch that video because what that'll talk about is the filming part of it, how to film video in a way that will make for an awesome video that people want to watch. So in this one, we've kind of talked about how to get it on your computer, how to edit it, but how do you film it to make a great video? Definitely right up there, check out that video. Hopefully you enjoyed this one. If you did, subscribe, thumbs up, give it that like. There's another feature that I always forget to recommend, but there's a bell that you can click right next to the subscribe button. If you click that, then you'll get notifications in your email every time a new video is uploaded. So you're a super fan, so obviously you're gonna wanna get those
Ring the bell, baby, ring that bell.
We'll see you tomorrow.